a little something in their life and watch their whole demeanor change. Watch his whole conversation change. Watch his worship change. Watch his prayer life change. Watch his community outreach change. Every aspect of his life gonna change because one thing got touched. And it becomes a ripple effect. Devil, you know. Because he kind of ate me. He kind of ate me. This is what he does. All right, you can test him, the Lord said. Do whatever you want with him. Take everything he possesses. But do him no physical harm. Wait a minute. I want you to catch something. God didn't bet on you that you can hit rock bottom. And anybody ever hit rock bottom? Anybody keep hitting rock bottom? And anybody ever hit the bottom and thought you bounced lower? I'm sorry, maybe that was just me. You know. Lord, can't nothing worse happen than what is already going on. And all of a sudden, I got kicked in the butt again. But I'm still here. I've been chosen. God ain't gonna let him take my life. Well, I think he might take the people away from me. He might take money away from me. He might take stuff away from me. He might take fame away from me. He might take comfort away from me. He might take my pillows from up underneath my head in my bed. But he ain't gonna take my life. Because I've been chosen. Wait a minute. So I guess I got a reason. Oh, I've been chosen. Wait a minute. Oh, I'm alive. Oh, that trick didn't work. I'm sorry, let me get off my O's. I'm gonna be on all day. All day long. Trust me, there's an anointing in my O. The reason why your life wasn't took is because you've been anointed. Because you've been chosen. I want you to understand that the anointed are always gonna run into all kinds of hell because you're the most dangerous to the kingdom of hell. Job was dangerous. You are a community. You are a force. You are a factor. You are an influence. You're an example and don't even know you're an example. People watching you and you don't even know they're watching you because they're watching you from a distance trying to figure out how you got where you are and what you've been doing while you've been doing it and how you keep doing it in the midst of all of what's going on. And ain't nobody else looking but you and you thinking, well, it's me, 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 me. Well, it's me, well, me, 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 me. And they sitting there like, I was talking when they had it. Where are they confessing at now? So I want you to understand your confession just ain't what you speak out your mouth. Your confession is the facts of. Confession is the speaking of the evidence. Faith is the substance. What is it? Faith is the substance. Faith is the substance. Of things hope for. But it's the evidence. Wait a minute. Confession is the speaking of the evidence. The speaking of the evidence. Well, here's the problem. If it's evidence that they can't see, they gonna think you crazy. But you ain't crazy. You chosen. Is the substance of things hoped for. And the evidence. The evidence. Confession is the speaking of the evidence of facts. The fact of the matter is God said you win. Wait a minute. The devil said you win in Job. Because you chose it. But what's your confession? See, facts really ain't the truth. They just what you believe. Let me repeat that. Facts ain't always the truth. It's just what you believe. Why would I say that? The fact of the matter is, it felt like spring outside yesterday. And some folks believe it, including your pastor, because I had a pair of shorts on for a minute. But the Lord's like, son, the truth of the matter is, it's February the 11th. It's still winter time. Cover your buttocks. Cover your jiggly parts. You still fat. You don't even have on shorts right now. Yes, Lord, and we don't put on some sweat. But if I start confessing, oh, winter's over, winter's over, winter's over, and I confuse everybody else with my influence and my confession, I'm now the blind leading the blind. I ain't even confessing faith because God didn't declare winter over. The evidence of things not seen. Here's the problem. Many times I'm confessing the evidence of what I already saw. Ooh. The evidence of what I already felt. Ooh. The evidence of what I already been through. Ooh. The evidence of what hurt me or what could hurt me or what I thought might hurt me. That's cursing God. That is not cursing God, Pastor. Lord, this could hurt me. Yeah, if you wanted to. I have what's called permissive will. I'm going to give you permission to allow that to hurt you. Or you can step in on faith and knock everything clean on down. Am I going to tell you you ain't going to suffer a little bit? Am I going to tell you that you ain't going to go through something a little bit? Am I going to tell you that you ain't going to have some problems and it might take a little while? No, I ain't going to tell you that. But what I will tell you is this. You win. Wait a minute. My Bible told me that the devil told God that Job won before the fight even started. Even though he was still going to fight him. Remember I told you he's kind of smart, but he's stupid. Here's a problem. If we get provoked into believing his confession and not God's confession, we do lose. Hey! We lose out on what was in position for us to be there, but we took off running in the other direction, so we can't have what we're supposed to have because we didn't want it. It's God's permissive will. Does it mean that I don't win? No, it don't mean I don't win. It just means that, okay, he not answering. He just, it's just on delay right now. It's on back order. Anybody order something in the mail and it just didn't show up on time? It was on back order. It snowed in New York. So it had to happen that way. Took a little longer. But if you don't stand for what it is that the promise is, you ain't no better than Esau. You really think Esau couldn't wait probably another hour or two for mama cooked up some lamb? No, give me the stew now, clown. The heck with birthright? Man, the heck with that? God ain't did nothing for me. Well, if God really wanted me to have some, he wouldn't have put that stew in my face right now. If God was really blessing me, he wouldn't let me have these hunger pains right now. If God was really on my side, I wouldn't feel the way that I feel right now. Esau mentality. If you are always looking for a cuddly, wuddly God, you're going to get kicked in your butt quite a bit because you were chosen. Now, for that baby, that's how bad, you know, that baby. Ooh, the baby got to be provided for. That's cuddly, wuddly God. But when you grow up, you got to let that baby fall as they crawling and trying to walk. Oh, okay, I'm sorry. Wait a minute, when they get on their bike and they go down the hill, and you talking about go down the hill because they might run into a dog on a lamppost, and they run into the lamppost, you make them walk back, and then you get their wounds. Yeah, I remember that. Don't fool yourself. I ran into that stop sign. You told me don't go down that hill. Mm-hmm. But you had to let them lick their wounds a little bit. You got to give them an opportunity to grow up a little bit. Wait a minute, when they get grown and they bounce their first check, you can't sit back and, I'm just going to do it for them. No, you got to learn some responsibility for the actions in which you take, for the confession that you putting out there. And God said, I got to be a grown man over there. That's Job, grown man. That's my boy. Devil, I'm going to let you test him. Can't kill him, but you can take everything from him. You can take everything. I'm sitting there reading it, I'm really having a hard time. Like, how can you allow that kind of suffering? I'm sitting at the computer, this is what he said. If I allowed you to suffer, does it mean I don't like you? Does it mean I don't love you? That's that politically correct answer that I was about to tell. You know, I'm gonna get it explicit. Hell no, because I shouldn't have to suffer. I'm a brat. I want what I want when I want it. I'm just being real. And then all of a sudden, the Lord said, if you gotta suffer a little bit more. And he started reminding me of suffering times. I'm like, yeah, you was there. But you was there. You know, and I want to tell him something bad, but every time I get ready to tell him something bad, I think about the next level where he brought me out of. See, I want you to catch this, you know. I'm sitting here and I'm suffering and I'm feeling alone, and all of a sudden, I'm going to bring your friend. But I'm still feeling alone, and I don't know what to do. Okay, well, I'm going to push you out of church. But I'm still feeling alone, and I don't understand what I'm going through. I don't understand the word. I don't understand it. Okay, well, I'm going to send you a mentor. So now I got a mentor, a friend, and I've been kicked out of the church I was in. To where I had to go higher. But I'm still suffering. I don't understand it. And I don't get this process. Now my wife leaves me again and I don't have nobody else. Oh God. And then the kids are going, oh God. He got me right where he wanted me. Mm-hmm. But in the middle of all this suffering, turn to Romans 5. Heck with that. To come to our lives to grow us up. It will allow tribulation to come to our life to give us strength. Because I want you to understand something. When you persevere through something, when you come out of it, you're stronger. Mm-hmm. Wait a minute. When you had to persevere through something for a long time, it begins to test your character a little bit. It tests who you are on the inside that don't nobody else know, but they got to vouch for it. Mm-hmm. It's that consistent confession of faith. Uh-oh, faith is the substance of things hoped for, but the evidence of things not seen. Evidence being confession, because confession is the evidence or the speaking of the evidence of the facts that you have. What are your facts? The Lord had to ask me that question. If you've been chosen to be a pastor, if you've been chosen to be a prophet, if you've been chosen to be a teacher, if you've been chosen to be a bum, and I put you through suffering, does it mean I love you any less? Is it thankful? I'm sorry. We got it twisted. Because we've been blaming them for something he was orchestrating in a meeting in heaven. You've been chosen. Hey, why don't you consider my partner over here? You know, they upright. They showing they headed down that right track. You know, let them get a little exercise with you. You can do this, this, and this, because God's going to set the limitation of what you can bear. He'll never give you more than you can bear. He's going to set the limitation. Problem is, guess what? Because we've already set the limitation of what we're going to allow. When the suffering comes, woe is me. There's some bull I can't do. And you slide into this whole brand new character. This whole new person. This whole new facade. Until you get what you want. See, I can go into the story of how Job got stripped of all these things, but why? You've been chosen to be tested. But it's there to build something in you. It's there to bring something out of you. Good, bad, and indifferent. How can I count it all joy when I'm steadily counting what's wrong? When I'm going through divers temptations, how can I count anything joy when I got, they did it like this, they shouldn't have did this, they couldn't have did this, and it shouldn't be like this, and God, I'm pissed at you because you allowed it. Ain't no way in hell you love me like you say you love me if I gotta go through this. Because love don't hurt nobody. Love don't feel like this. Well, let me ask you a question. When Jesus got on that cross and they nailed him, did it feel good? Somebody read me John 3:16. Come on, somebody read me John 3:16. Wait a minute, God so loved what?
The world.
That he gave his only begotten what? Wait a minute, I ain't giving nobody my kid. Will you? Let alone my own life. But we got the audacity to sit back and tell somebody how they got the right to love us. When we were chosen to be loved. He handpicked us in this love. Ain't no way in hell you can sit back and say that your mama didn't love you when she whooped your butt. So why are we mad at God? Why are we mad at the people God puts in our lives to do it? Because God uses people. Why are we so mad about being chosen? This is a privilege. It's many other people out here that don't even want to be chosen. Some folks didn't get handpicked. Their time was up. I'm alive. I'm chosen. I'm loved. I'm provided for. But yet I'm depressed. But yet I'm not thankful. But yet, I can find everything under the sun behind my old to tell a story that ain't Christ's. The true confession that you're supposed to have is that of Christ. Here's what's funny. Job did not know who Christ was. people to love me. Are you crazy? These are the questions that I'm getting at my computer. How dare you tell me how to love you? I created you. I made you. I put everything in you, and I got the right to bring it out when I want to. You were chosen. But if you want to be Esau, go back to Edom, go hunting, and miss out on everything. See, the funny part about Esau was this. Esau was so bitter. I'm going to help y'all out. You ready? And I'm going to read you something from Wednesday night. We're going to shut it down. You ready? Esau was so bitter that he thought he lost his birthright, but was still living in the land that was given to him. He had all the riches of his daddy. Because guess what? Joseph stole the birthright, but he left the birthright behind. I mean, Jacob did it and left the birthright behind. Wait a minute. Jacob stole the blessing. But somehow, some way, Esau was still walking in that blessing. But he was so darn bitter. He was so darn torn up. He was so darn self-absorbed that he couldn't even see that he was still blessed. He cursed his own blessing because he wouldn't accept it. He couldn't receive the goods of God. Because guess what? The fact said that Jacob did this to me. So I'm mad at Jacob. I'm mad at God. I'm mad at my daddy. I'm mad at everybody. For no reason. What God has for me is for who?
Me.
You've been chosen. You're not excluded from what Job had. You're not excluded to the gifts of Jesus. So what God has for you is for who?
Me.
Stop talking about what you ain't got. Watch this. Maybe he got to turn up the pressure a little bit to bring it out of you. Maybe he got to let some folks tick you off and walk out your life and use you and abuse you and this, that, and the other so that you have the heart that you're supposed to have in order to walk in that gifting and that calling and have the grace to be able to do it as Christ would. Oh, I'm sorry. You can teach that. No, you can't teach grace. You can teach to get. No, you really can't. I can give you all the knowledge in the world, which are nothing more than facts. But until there's some evidence that I can't see, the gifts are no good to nobody. Jesus. Gifts are activated by faith. Grace is activated by faith. Life is lived by faith. Wait a minute. Worship is dictated by what?
Faith.
So if you ain't got what?
Faith.
You ain't got nothing. There is no activation in your life. So if you're missing something in your life, maybe your evidence is wrong. Maybe the facts of what you've been trying to put together is really wrong. Before I go to Hebrew, I'm going to go back to Job. I'm going to read you the last verse. Boy, I'm going to preach that sermon over. Right, you stay right there. I got you.
You're going to make more stuff fall off.
No, I'm not. Jesus.
Thank you.
I got grace. You better push Ricky. Go back to Job. I'm going to go to the last verse. The last couple of verses. Let's start at verse 1. Job stood up and tore his robe in grief. Then he shaved his head and fell to the ground in worship. He said, I came naked from my mama's womb, and I will be naked when I leave. The Lord gave me what I had, and the Lord taketh away. Praise the name of the Lord. In all of this, Job did not sin by blaming God. I want you to catch something. Job lost all his cattle. He lost all his kids. He lost everything. 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 all happened within a matter of days. Anybody ever had one of them suddenlies where everything was real smooth and all of a sudden you look up and you're like, what the hell did just happen here? Wait a minute, you was chosen to go through this. Oh, wait a minute, this wasn't no orchestrated plan by man against you. No, this was something on a deeper level. This was something a little more demonic. This was something that had to do with some other world type stuff because it happened in other world type of time. And God wanted to test your character. He wanted to see whether or not you was going to stand for him, stand up and worship, stand up and be counted, stand up and say, I'm chosen. And because I'm chosen, it don't matter what the hell you do. You took it, but what you took wasn't mine to take in the first place because I came into this world with nothing. I'm going to leave this world with nothing but God. Coveting. Wait a minute. He could have coveted the people in his life. He could have coveted the stuff in his life. He could have coveted the influence in his life. He could have coveted the power that he had in his life. But instead he said, I covet my God. Because I can't take that stuff to heaven with me. I want you to understand, for the events that took place right then and there, the devil's plan was, I'm going to turn this nigga bitter against God. I'm going to make him cuss God. I'm going to make him hate God. I'm going to make him hate anything that got to do with God. Because I'm going to take everything in the land of selfishness and I'm going to make him want it. He's going to sit there, woe is me, talking about reciting his ain't gots. He can't call it all joy because he counted his ain't gots. I ain't got no more kids. I'm shuffling around again. I ain't got no more cows. I'm strutting around again. They done killed my servants. I ain't got nobody bring me no breakfast. I'm shuffling around again. I mean, just kicking everything around. And really all he doing when he kicking, he really thinking that's God's head. He trying to kick God clean up out of his life. But instead of that, he said, okay, you took that. Yeah, I ain't really digging it. I ain't feeling this. But I'm going to go into worship, and I'm going to tell you how I feel in real talk. Because I don't want my confession to change. Because if I change my confession, I'm really sitting back confessing that my character really ain't what I was displaying when I had it. So I'm just going to say, oh, I ain't got nothing else to say, but oh. I can't complain about it. God, oh. This, oh, it hurt. Oh, God. Oh! What's really in your heart? Because the character of a man is going to be shown. It's going to start spewing from here to here. What's really in your heart? Is it a no? Because see, oh can mean I'm hurting. Oh can mean I'm happy. Oh can mean I don't really know. Oh can mean I'm shocked. Watch this. Oh can mean that I'm chosen. And I don't really like it right now, but I'm going to accept it and I'm going to see what God's going to do by faith. I bet you didn't know you was chosen. Bet you didn't know. I ain't gonna go to Hebrews. I ain't gonna go there. That's a whole nother sermon. Thank you, Jesus. I ain't gonna go there. Bet you didn't know you was chosen. But guess what? You're now accountable to being chosen. So the next time you get them crazy suddenlies, the next time you get them off-the-wall battles, the next time you get to sitting in your fifis and wondering how in the heck did I become so emotional, know that you've been chosen. And know that it's probably just a little bit of a test that God done bet on you to win. again, I'm still battling with it. Nah, for real, you just gonna double down on me like that, right? You just, y'all ain't having been 20s on me. And then I got two stacks on me. That boy good. And I'm sitting there like, you just gonna double down on me. How much pressure you gonna put on me, nigga? I can't be losing your money. Can't lose your currency. I ain't no quitter, but why you gotta put so much pressure on me? Why I gotta feel this way? Son, let me help you. The devil already said you won. Christ on the cross said you won. In the beginning, I said you won. Mm-hmm. When are you gonna get it? If your enemy telling you you gonna win, and your friends telling you you gonna win, and your daddy telling you you gonna win, when you gonna confess you win? Mm-hmm. You've been chosen to do it. You've been chosen to do it. Let your character show it. It's like praise out.
Father, I thank and praise you that you chose us, that you handpicked us, that you singled us out to be picked out, to be picked on. And that many times we don't even understand what's happening. I thank you for enlightening our understanding to know that we have already attained the victory. And if God be for us, let us get this down in our spirit that who in this world, out of this world, under this world, could be against us. We thank and praise you for the victory that we have attained through Christ Jesus. I pray that you give us revelation of that victory, that we don't have to fight for the victory, that we can fight from the victory.
Yes.
I give you praise and I give you glory and honor that you have chosen us. You have ordained and you have appointed. You've already decided and predestined before the foundation of this world that we should go forth and bring you much fruit. And sometimes that fruit from the character of Christ has got to be formed in us. And after it's formed in us, we got to learn how to pour it out of us.
Yes.
We got to come past our emotions and our affections and our understanding. And that we would pour forth from the fruit of Christ. Let the fruit be formed in us. Let you be glorified in us as you produce much fruit in our lives, Father. Even a fruitful plant has got to be pruned and cut back so it can produce more in that season. I thank and praise you, Father, that we will not despise your process that you take us through to be fruitful so that the character of Christ can shine forth in our lives. I give you glory, I give you honor as you pour upon us more grace, Father, in the midst of the hell, more grace in the midst of the struggle, more grace in the midst of the trials and tribulations, knowing that you after something in us, oh God. I thank and praise you for the patience that you're even producing in us. That if we can't say nothing good, help us by the grace of God, through the blood of Jesus, to keep our mouths shut.
Yes,
we
God.
Shut down every negative thought, every negative word, every negative action in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And pray that you be glorified in the midst of this. That we'll get our eyes off our situation, get our eyes off our circumstances, and look unto Jesus, who is the author and the finisher of our faith. Now let faith and let you do a perfect work in us. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Are there any questions?